Hi guys! So I am filming two videos in one day, so if you've seen this face and this look and this makeup before, I'm sorry. Let's continue with this video. So today I'm going to be showing you guys how to make a DIY natural dry shampoo. I'm so excited. I'm basically going to be showing you guys how to save yourself from washing your hair every day, which is fantastic because you're actually not supposed to wash your hair every day, so this is going to help you do that. You know what I mean? So, this actually kind of looks like drugs, but it's not, I promise. So I'm going to tell you guys my story with dry shampoo. So, I actually got the Tresemme dry shampoo, and I used it a couple times. I didn't really like it, just because when I sprayed it in my hair and, like, moved it around, it looked really good for about an hour or two. But after that, I kind of felt like the oils in my hair just, like, gradually, like, just overtook it and made my hair look oily again. So, today I'm going to be showing you guys how to make your own, and it's actually not bad for you. It doesn't have any chemicals or anything in it. It's just two things that you probably have in your cupboard right now. And, yeah, let's go ahead and get started. Okay, so, like I said, this is what it looks like. I just have mine in a bowl. So, basically, all you're going to need is, all you're going to need is baking soda and cornstarch. So basically all you're going to do is take half cornstarch and half baking soda, whatever measurements you want. If you're making just a little bit, do a teaspoon and a teaspoon. If you're making a lot like I did, do like a half a cup and a half a cup. And you're going to mix that together and put it in a bowl, and voila, you have your dry shampoo. So I'm sorry, I just, So you're going to mix it together in a bowl, and bam, you got your dry shampoo. So this is actually fantastic for my hair specifically, because I do, dye my hair. I get highlights in it, so my grow out is darker than my regular hair, so this actually blends in perfectly with my hair and makes me look like I have all one colored hair, if that makes sense. But if you do have brown hair and you want to try this recipe, another thing you can do is add cocoa powder to it and mix it up until you get your darker hair color, because this is white. I haven't tried it on anyone dark haired before, but I'm guessing it would probably just kind of just melt into your head. If not, go ahead and add some cocoa powder to it and you get your dry shampoo. So I'm gonna go ahead and just show you guys how to do it, because let's be real here. This is what we want to see. So my hair is kind of a little greasy, so I'm going to go ahead and, guys, get ready for the craziness of the Lion Mane. The Lion Mane! Okay, so you guys can see my hair is kind of greasy right here. You guys can see. You see what I see? Okay, now we're going to fix that. So basically, all I do, you can do this a lot of different ways. I just like to take my fingers and then just start by putting that onto my roots and just basically just like rubbing it in. There's really no like right or wrong way to do this. And you can get it like in your roots and all around and party and have fun. So like I said, you guys can see that it actually, like, it looks good with my hair because I do have blonde hair. You can add cocoa powder to get it to your shade. You can also put this in like a shaker type of bottle so that you don't have to use your fingers if you don't want to. And you can also put it in your palm and then just rub your hands together and do that. I like to use my fingers though, because I feel like I get more direct application. So I'm just gonna go ahead. Sorry if I look like I'm frowning, because I am. I'm frowning at you, girl. And then just go ahead and just keep putting it all over your hair and just blending it in. And, you know, that's basically how this thing works. You just do what you gotta do to be who you wanna be. And you know, it's just pretty cray-cray. This life is just not easy. I mean, there's just a lot of things. I look like I'm gray. An old lady. So after I go ahead and put it through my scalp, I just go ahead and just, sorry you can't see, I just run my hands through my fingers and just kind of comb it through, and voila, dying girl, your hair looks great. So you guys can see the after. Like I said, this is a little ashy, but I did put a lot of this on, so, that's the after. Look it, it's not greasy anymore, and it actually, like, helps with my hair. Like I said, if you have dark hair, go ahead and add some cocoa powder in there, and bam, you got freshly washed, really nice hair, and this actually does work. Like, it actually keeps my hair grease-free even until the next day. So, I hope this was helpful to you guys. I hope you guys try it out, especially if you're blonde, give this a try. And like I said, if you're not blonde, just add some cocoa powder, and you smell like chocolate at the same time. So, I mean, it's like win-win. And also, you can add a little less than I did. I did put a lot in. But that is my DIY dry shampoo. I really like this. And my friend thought it was drugs when she came over, but it's not. So that's okay. That's fabulous. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And I hope you give it a try and tell me how it works for y'all. And if you have any tips or tricks or magic, then leave them down below. And I'll talk to you guys.